Father, we are so thankful to be here today. Thank you for your many wonderful blessings. Thank you for our students and for how many talents and abilities you've given them, and thank you for their willingness to work for your glory. Whether it be our kindergarten graduates, our grade 8 graduates, or any of our students in between, we just are so thankful. And this is a night to honor and recognize our students and their hard work. Tonight for families to celebrate and friends, and we just invite you here tonight, and we ask that you be present. We pray that this will just be a wonderful night, and all God's people say,
Amen.
Now you need something. It is wonderful. Able to celebrate together as one large school family. We're here to celebrate kindergarten graduates. We're here to celebrate grade 8 graduates. Both levels moving to a different level. Kindergartens will get less playtime, and you guys don't get recess anymore. We're excited, parents. If there's a picture you need, please come up and get it. And if we move too fast, yell at us and we'll slow down. I realize that we got a late start. I apologize for that. What am I going to get? I've got 7 students on time. We're done 7. We've got 4 left. We can't cut them out. So the night's going to go long. If you have younger kids and you need to go at some point, that's fine. You're released. But we're here. We're going to be here for a couple hours. Let's enjoy it. It's actually warmer here than I thought. It's not as hot as it normally is, but it's still getting warm. But it's just going to be a great night of celebration. We're going to start with our kindergarten grads, and then we will move into our grades and some awards that are open to the whole school, and then some serious stuff at the end as well. If you've never been to a TCS grad before, they are a little bit different. We really try to make them personal. If you're going to leave here knowing more about our graduates than you need to know, probably. But you're going to know a lot about them and the fun and the great treasures that they are. And there's a little bit of funny humor, but it's all done in good spirits. And trust me when I say that our graduates will be disappointed. They're looking forward to hearing what is going to be said about them. So I'm going to now ask Mrs. Gates, our kindergarten teacher, to come up, and Mrs. Grimm's going to as well. And they're going to do the kindergarten graduation diploma. So kindergarten parents, if you'd like to kind of work your way up and get in here.
Well, we have had just a fantastic year in the kindergarten class. This year we've enjoyed a class of 22 students. And it's been a pleasure to have Mrs. Grimm in the class as well. We love working together, and we count it a privilege to be able to teach your children. So thank you for entrusting them to us. Well, this morning, or tonight, pardon me, we've got 12 senior kindergarten graduates. So boys and girls, when I say your name, you may walk up and shake Mrs. Grimm's hand first. Then I will shake your hand and give you your kindergarten diploma. We will start with Bailey Boyd. Bailey comes to school every day with a bright, big smile on her face. We appreciate her care and concern for others. Her favorite kindergarten memory is making crafts. And when she grows up, she wants to be a cupcake maker. Next, we have Kai Grant. Kai is so enthusiastic and so much fun to be around. We've appreciated his good attitude and hard work. His favorite kindergarten memory has been our field trips, and when he grows up, he wants to be a professional golfer. Kyler Hicks. Kyler has shown good progress this year, and we have been so proud to see him participating in class. His favorite kindergarten memory is our trip to Storybook Park, and when he grows up, he wants to be a police officer. She wants to be a nurse.
with you. They might be getting restless, but sometimes they go in the back and then you're making a lot of noise and that takes away from others. So if you can keep your child with you, that would be awesome. And like I said, if you need to go early, that's fine as well. Not you guys. Grade 1 to 4, please. Grade 1 to 4.
Thank you. Ah! time. lot about music. He's either playing it on his guitar or blaring it on his Bluetooth speaker, or even playing it on the piano in the music room whenever he has the chance to. One thing is for sure, Jaden can always provide the music.
But Jaden isn't always like this. He is often found doing his homework about 10 minutes before it is due. No matter how big the project is, it could be 10 questions in grammar or half an essay, he'll have it done. It's probably not right, but at least it's done.
You'd think that Jaden would be very patient, considering he has 5 younger siblings, but he isn't. Well, at least not in grammar class or language arts. He's either making sarcastic remarks or just rolling his eyes. He doesn't usually get caught, but he did once. And let's just say, Mrs. Torrey wasn't too happy. He likes most sports, such as baseball, badminton, and volleyball, but his absolute favorite of 100%, no matter what, is running. He just absolutely loves it. It could be the 1500, 400, he loves it all. And don't forget about them sprints, he loves them. Especially when he has to do it against everybody else.
But there is one thing when he doesn't score, he has to take a stomp. Whether he's reading for the birdie in badminton or about to take a jump in high jump, it's like he stomps really fast or something. It's weird. Jaden is also one of the funniest people we know, even when he's not trying. From Googling funny jokes or just being sarcastic, he's most likely going to make you laugh.
On our trip to the district on the way back, we were playing an innocent game of truth or dare. Jaden was there to give the girls his phone. And, well, let's just say that they found some interesting things. But one thing that sticks out is a video that goes something like this. Yo, 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 it's Jaden boy!
Selfies on it, or she'll send me a whole bunch of pictures on Snapchat with her and her string. So unfortunately for her, and fortunately for me, I now have a collection of 138 photos of Ella, and only one of them is good. Most of the set pictures have a great story behind them, and I unfortunately can't fit them all in this page. Even with all of Ella's insanity and shortcomings, she's still an amazing friend. When you are with her, you can always count on having a fit of laughter, a noose inside joke, and an amazing new memory. Shout out to Bames. Hanging out with Ella is nothing short of an adventure every time. But when times get serious, you can count on her for support and comfort. She'll always be there to make things better and to lift you up. Her positivity can lighten the whole room. Ella, even when your positive attitude can drive me insane, the light never stops being you. Don't let others bring you down. They expect you to fall, but instead surprise them by growing. I don't know what my time here would have been like without one of my besties. Probably okay, but far duller. I can't wait for the crazy and fun memories to come, because awesome friends plus good times equal amazing memories.
Comment on it. Brianna loves to laugh. If you know her,
knows what she wants and how she wants it. Brianna wants to become a paramedic and live with her future dogs to come. She already knows what dogs and cats she wants and is waiting to be able to get them on her own. She loves dogs more than you can imagine. She loves dogs even more than us.
Brianna, you are truly one of a kind. You have always brought lots of excitement and laughs to our class. Brianna, you have been an amazing student, classmate, and most importantly, a friend. Now that we are graduating, we hope you'll still bring the laughs in high school.
Talk. His ear's like a whole bunch of spaghetti noodles flopping everywhere.
system, but once he makes his mind, there's no changing it. But I did manage to get him on the back at Wonder Gym, and we took the front seat. Well, let me just say that I've never seen him so scared in my life. I'm not sure if he was asleep with a nightmare that was coming true, or he was having a heart attack. All that aside, though, Adam was a great person to have around, and we wish him well as he goes to high school. I can't wait to see what you do with your athletic abilities in high school.
Hannah is great at sports and always puts in her best effort.
loves volleyball and badminton. And to add to that list of amazing talents, she's amazing at doing hair and all things art. We hope you have a great time in high school, Hannah. We know you will do great. Anna Noelle Poole was born on September 21st, 2005, in Lethbridge, Alberta. She joined us in the second grade and has been lots of fun since she arrived. Anna can always make you smile and is a caring friend. She's great at sports and is a hardworking student. She always tries her best in everything and is very funny.
In her earlier grades, Anna was a wild one. You could call her the class clown. She was always messing around and you could constantly catch her smiling.
In the fifth grade, Anna had a strange obsession with bobcats. She used to make tons of drawings of them and was always talking about them. She even made a campaign for class president. She would make signs and say, "Bobcat for president." In grade six, Anna would always volunteer to pray for lunch or to pray at the end of the day. If she was chosen, Anna would go on for a minimum of 5 minutes, praying for everyone's pets, cups, bruises, and anything else she could think to stall time. The prayer would go on forever, and by the end of the year, she never got called to pray on anymore. In seventh grade, things toned down a bit. Anna is now a laid-back, fun-to-hang-around person. She can still always make you laugh and has quite a quirky personality, though sometimes her wild side springs up out of nowhere.
For example, bubbly hands are physically something Anna can't get enough of. It all started when Mr. B got hooked on drinking these bubbly, sugarless drinks. One day, Mr. B was done his can of bubbly and thought it'd be a good idea to put it in Anna's desk when she was gone. Little did Mr. B know that he had started a war over bubbly cans. Day after day, he would find mysterious bubbly cans around his office. And when April Fool's Day rolled around, Anna had big plans. She would strike back once and for all. She collected cans of bubbly around the classroom, outer recycling bins, and even some from Anna's house. From there at recess, Mr. B was outside on yard duty. Anna and a couple hid around 30 cans in his office, some of which are probably not yet found. But from then on, I don't think I've seen a single can lying around the school.
This year, at the TVN volleyball tournament, the girls' team had made it to the final, and it was game point. We won the match, and Anna jumped up into a legendary dance of joy and started to cheer. It was very funny to watch. Anna had a huge smile on her face. This just goes to show that Anna's always trying her best and is invested in her team.
We couldn't imagine our class without you. Good luck in high school, Anna. We know you'll do great. Basketball aren't the Baker Valedictorian. Nori's this year's valedictorian, and rightfully so. She's endlessly preparing for her next class, making study notes, highlighting, and rereading. Sometimes you have to pull her away from her, and when you do, you see how fun and kind she really is. Nori has a wonderful personality that will take her far in high school. She has a drive to excel in everything, whether it's sports, school, or being a great friend. Nori, we hope high school is a blast, and you continue being the great student and friend that you are.
Rohan Seni was born on October 4th, 2004. He joined our school in senior kindergarten. Rohan is a great and important part of our class. He likes to laugh and joke around. Last year, when Rohan was in grade 7, he was doing his devotion. And when we do devotions, we have an activity at the end before we pray. So Rohan chose to do origami as his activity. He wanted to teach the whole class how to make paper dragons. Anyways, 45 minutes later, half the class had quit, and the other half was not even doing it right. Miss Toy was still waiting, but eventually she had to end it since we had to do grammar. Rohan is a little obsessed with origami still. In fact, last year he had his very own shelf. That very shelf was for every time Rohan was caught playing with his origami figures. Every time Mr. Patel looked at him and saw Rohan looking down and folding paper, he would take Rohan's origami and put it on the shelf. It had gotten to the point where you couldn't see the bottom of the shelf because of the amount of paper cannons and paper dragons he had made. Rohan loves to play with his laser pen and shine it in your eyes. He used to talk about a game called Animal Jam, and I think he is still secretly playing it. Rohan always does weird Fortnite dances like the Orange Justice. When we went on a year-end trip to Word of Life in Canada's Wonderland, Rohan didn't know how to get into his sleeping bag. He tried to open it from the bottom, and he had no idea how to roll up the sleeping bag. He also didn't know how to start a fire. He put the paper on top of fire instead of the bottom. When we went to Canada's Wonderland, Rohan wore the same t-shirt the whole time with nothing over top of his t-shirt. So Rohan was soaking and freezing the whole time that we were there. We all hope Rohan has a great time in high school, and we will miss him here at TCS. Thank you, Rohan, for bringing many laughs to our class.
Our Junior Boy Award goes to Seth Boy.
Thank you.
presenting. Alex, would you like me to explain the award, or would you like to? The Champions for Christ Award. This award was established in memory of Alex Torrey Sr. to recognize sportsmanship in individual and team athletics, as well as recognizing commendable athletic ability. Qualifications for sportsmanship include exhibiting a team spirit, demonstrating servant leadership, showing graciousness in victory and defeat, and recognizing athletic ability as a gift of God. Alex, would you present?
So we have two awards tonight. The first one will go to Anna Poole.
Thank you. Albert Munsoff Technical Award was established in memory of my father, who was a construction superintendent. So this award is handed out to a grade 8 graduate who shows an aptitude and desire to work with her hands. The recipient will be hardworking and an industrious individual who likes to build or create. And this year the award goes to Jaden Roy.
Thank you. even when it means compromising what may be most comfortable for her. In graciously welcoming others to our class and seeking to be a friend at all times, she demonstrates what it means to show God's love to others. I'm pleased to present this award to Neil Stang.
Diligence, meaning that the student strives hard, working at everything to the best of his
kindness to others, meaning that the student tries to get along well with other students, respect for teachers and other adults in the school setting, and good participation in all of the school's activities. Shelly, would you present the award?
In memory of my grandfather and on behalf of the Vanscape and family, I am pleased to present this to Hannah.
Johnson. Yeah. quite entertaining. She always has something funny to say or do at least 10 times a day. For example, when we went to Word of Light for our class trip this year, Anna saw 3% milk, and oh boy, don't even get me started about how furious she was. Anna literally ranted for 5 minutes about how 3% milk shouldn't be a thing. Anna, I love your humorous and unique personality, and I've learned that you definitely dislike 3% milk. Brianna is very confident, whether it's presenting in front of the class or in front of the school. She excels in everything that she does. She's joyful and always seems to have a smile on her face. Brianna, you have taught me to be comfortable with myself in front of other people and confident. Jody has very strong opinions. If she doesn't like something you do or say, she will make sure to let you know. For example, Jody absolutely despises boys wearing capris. She told me her reasoning for this, and I quote, because it looks so weird. Jody also says the most random things at the most random time. Like, isn't it weird that it's cold and it's summer? Or, hey, can you make blueberry pie? No, wait, apple, grapefruit, milk. I'm sorry, Jody, but when did milk become a pie for her? One of the things that I like about you, Jody, is how you can make anything funny to laugh about and how you're a weird yet fun person. I learned from you to stick to what I believe in, even if everything goes a different way. Ella is amazingly artistic. Ella has always been artistically and musically inclined and is quite the perfectionist. Once we were painting on ceiling tiles and she had quite a long journey with hers. Almost every day we went to class, she was working on hers trying to make it better. Each time she was done painting, she would decide she didn't like it and would paint another coat on it until she thought it was perfect. Ella, it's your motivation to be the best and perfectionist qualities that have inspired me to complete anything I do with the feeling of being proud. Jaden can be very intense at times. For example, when we went to Word of Life, Mr. B was so scared of Jaden that he made sure he was on the same team as him. But the lucky ones who weren't on it, his team, including myself, got shot many times and ended up with painful welts. Jaden's overall personality can be pretty sarcastic and kind of odd, which can be really funny at times. Earlier today, we were doing our annual auction in math. Jaden's group ended up taking dog treats. The weird thing is that Jaden actually ate some of it, even after we found out they were dog treats. Jaden, your humorous personality and your overall sarcastic and odd demeanor can make anyone laugh. Erica is probably the most energetic and fun person I know. She is very easygoing and is all around an amazing friend. She is very supportive when people are nervous or doubt themselves and is a great motivator. For example, in grade 3, we were running in cross country and I was about to stop for a break, but then all of a sudden, I felt a hard hand slap my back and push me till the end of the race. Erica, you are a loyal and trustworthy friend that anyone can go to. You have shown me to be supportive, caring, and fun even when there are obstacles in life. Rohan is always smiling and laughing no matter where he is. He constantly manages to find laughter and joy in everything he does. However, when you touch his hair, that can be quite a different story that will end up with him staring down. At the beginning of grade 8, Rohan found out what hair gel was, and, well, let's just say he never stopped using it since. When we were taking our class picture, it took Rohan 5 minutes until his hair was ready for pictures. Rohan, you have taught me to always find the best in things and be positive and joyful. Adam is one of the most driven individuals I know, and he always gives his best. He is always motivated to be the best and fastest in every sport that he does. He works hard to be the best at every sport, and it definitely helps that there's only two other boys. It's your drive that pushes me to always try my best in everything I do. Another thing that I like about Adam is that he also loves the Golden State Warriors. Okay, that's not completely true. However, I really do think you should vote for the winning team, the Warriors, for the best. We've had so many memories together, including playing Foursquare, House, Tag, Duck Duck Goose, and more. It seems like all these playing these games was just yesterday. And I'm speaking on behalf of my fellow classmates when I say that we have learned a lot of valuable lessons from our teachers and from each other. For example, we learned how to make origami during a 45-minute long devotion presentation
from Roma, and we will also never forget the song that teaches us how to punctuate our dialogue from Mrs. Torrey. Our teachers at TCS always push us to do our best. They shape us for the future and help us define our strengths for later in life, even if it means doing hours of grammar homework. Some of the most memorable times of our lives have been spent here at the school. From volleyball games to choir, Friday afternoon lives to plays, and class trips to passion lunch. We could have never done it without the help and motivation of our friends, parents, and teachers. So on behalf of the graduating class of 2019, I'd like to thank the principal, teachers, and staff of Timothy Christian School for caring about us, helping us learn and grow, and reminding us always to be respectful, responsible, and proud. We also want to thank our parents and family for all your hard work and support for sending us to a Christian school that teaches us about Christ and how to live our lives. Last and most importantly, I want to thank God for carrying us through to this graduation day and for bringing us all these amazing people in our lives. Before I close, I would like to share one last Bible verse with you that I've always found encouraging. Joshua 1:9 says, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous, do not be frightened, and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." Class of 2019, no matter where we go and no matter what we do, we must remember that God is always with us, and He has a big plan for all of us. As we move forward in our lives, whether it's high school or university, we need to remember that God has a plan for us, and He is ready to guide us no matter what. Our teachers have prepared us well for high school, and as we leave here tonight, we will use all the valuable lessons our teachers and classmates have taught us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Each one is going to come across, receive their diploma from me, get their school gift from this historian, and congratulations from below. So parents, if they want to come up and get pictures, they're more than welcome to do that. They will then go to that side, we will then get them in the middle, take a group picture, and we will pray with them, or over them. Jane David Hoy. Roman Somche. Shaker Seti.
The glory tonight is yours, and it will forever be yours. We commit this graduating class to you in the strong name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. Everybody, if you take your seat, go. Graduates, you can go back to your seats. We just have a few things to finish off tonight. It's extremely difficult, well, you as parents know, to say goodbye to students that you, some of them you spend 10 years with. And you've been through good times, fun times, hard times, all things. They've grown up with you. They're always welcome to come back. They do. The first PD day, we get a ton of them. It dwindles down a little bit after that. We have an alumni volleyball game that I'll get most of them to, but we look forward to seeing you, look forward to hearing about how things are going, and we're excited for you, but it's bittersweet. It's also bittersweet when we have to say goodbye to families. Some families that have been in the school longer than I have been here. This is my 11th year. I'd just like to acknowledge the families, Cameron, Krista, and Mark. We miss you. But remember, you guys are always a part of us. The Grimm family, Melanie, will still be here. We say goodbye to Melanie and Ben. Where's Melanie? I don't know if you remember, but you either called me the week we were closing up school year or the week before school. I can't remember that, but I remember I was in the kitchen doing a job. And you called and you said, we decided to enroll the kids. And do you remember what I said? Oh, come on. I said, you know what? That's an answer to prayer. Because there were three families that were in my heart. Yours was one. And I, for some reason, had the boldness to be able to tell you that. And I'm just really excited that you decided to make that commitment. The Osorik family, I remember when you moved from Kitchener 6.5 years ago. We've been so delighted to have you as part of our school. And we're in the journeys together. Sandy, I remember, actually when your family came up the first time, I was out of town. And remember, Paul McDonald showed you around the school. Do you remember Paul? But talked over the phone for a long time. And then for visa reasons, you weren't able to come that year. You were another year. But I'm really glad that your family and Cameron and Lori have been part of our school. The Heisman family. 17 years. Long time, haven't you? Have any of you cried at all tonight?
A little bit.
Richard, have you cried at all tonight? Vivian, you probably don't remember the first time I met you. And you were in school, it was the summer, I was trying to figure out what I was doing. And new building, I didn't even know where things were. And Vivian was clean. And you had those three kids sitting in desks for like hours. Obedient, reading, doing things, and it was wonderful to see. But I remember that. And the Logie family, Arlene and Greg, how many policies have we written? How many meetings have we sat in? How many times have you come into my office yelling and screaming at me? No, I'm just kidding. Thank you for all you've done for those families. Thank you for being part of it. Thank you for, the teachers would say the same thing, but for trusting us with your children every day. It's not easy to do. As parents, we have done. Thank you. We understand the tremendous responsibility. We hope that we know we have fallen short in areas, but we hope that we've done more good than bad. I say that halfway as a joke. That may be laughed at, but thank you. I'm going to ask, let me just a couple more thank yous. Jack back there, thank you. Jack's a graduate. Heather, thank you. CRC Church. for allowing us to use their church and hall, and Kareem for show of extra cleaning. We will get here tomorrow. The deal is we clean up, but we'll be here tomorrow. The sanctuary will be cleaned, and all of our stuff will be organized. And not that you have to do that, but Kareem is here, but she does it every year. And creating parents for decorating. Christina DeBoer and the crew for supper. It was awesome. We really appreciate that. And if I'm forgetting somebody, okay, we can clap for them. I'm going to ask Greg to come as our board chair. He's going to have a couple closing remarks. I'm going to close in prayer, and then the graduates will leave. Graduates, if you want to leave your stuff, your parents know where you're sitting, they can come get it. I don't have any idea if it's still raining out. I don't know. But they'll either be outside along the thing or in the hallway. Okay? And you can give me your congratulations to that. Great.
Thank you, Ed. I just want to thank God. I want to thank God for this school, for all the people that are involved in making this school what it is. Being in the school for 14 years, we've seen just incredible growth from so many students, and just such a professional and a staff that operates like a family, at least in my eyes, which has been a real blessing, and I'm sure it's been a blessing to the parents also. It's been a great joy to serve the school. And I just want to thank all the staff, Matt. I want to thank all the families that have been involved in this school, all the volunteer hours that people have put in, all the thought, the care, and the prayer that have gone in to make this school what it is today. I just wish and pray that the school will continue to grow. Matt and I were looking at numbers, and we're bubbling very close to 100 students. So it's been a tremendous blessing. And say good night.
Just a moment, as soon as I say amen, you can start playing. Graduates, we'll just go all that way. Father, thank you. We thank you for all of this. We thank you for these students, and we pray. We just pray that you be with them as they go. Thank you for this night, and just pray a blessing upon everyone. In your name we pray.
Girls, congratulations.